Hi guys, welcome to another bright and beautiful day in Manuel Antonio, which is the beach paradise in Costa Rica. It is Wednesday, it is 27 degrees here, and life is beautiful. It's pura vida. This is Manuel Antonio Town. It's small, but people stay here to get to the national park and some of the beaches, which are really pretty. It's also way better than local capos, and it's got some really nice hostels and restaurants, so I do recommend staying here. Hi guys, as you can probably tell, I'm in my bedroom back in London editing this, and this vlog is a little bit all over the place and not really well explained. Please bear with me, I'm still learning about this, but I get into a taxi and I go to the public beach for the first time. Super cute, like random animal on the side of the road. I don't know what it is, but I love it. Is it a tapir? Is it an anteater? It's bloody cute. Leave me a comment, please.
Later that night.
Wow, Jesus!
Oh, it looks so bad.
No, it's good.
Looks like this. The next morning.
Okay, I'm going to.
I spent a lot of time in hammocks here. And it's been really fun. I met some fun Irish people yesterday. Went to Manuel Antonio National Park. We had really good Thai food. Manuel Antonio was a beautiful place. There were epic, epic sunsets here. I stayed at the Vista Serena hostel. It was really, really nice. Met some really fun people. It's super social. It's got a really good view of the sea and some of the mountains here in Manuel Antonio. The epic, epic sunsets, run by such a nice guy called JC. I'm gonna miss him. He's such a cool dude. He set up beer pong a table for us yesterday in classic Brit style, and he also takes like a group out every Wednesday to Capos, the nearest city, to go out to a discotheque. But yeah, I'm gonna miss him. Seriously, it's like, it's a really good vibe here, but also the people make the place. I completely forgot. I hate packing and unpacking my bag constantly during traveling. That is something I totally forgot about, but here we are, being a gypsy and literally just packing and packing again and again and again. But that's hostel life, and that's what you get for the nomad. lifestyle. I don't know. So, traveling is hard sometimes and it just sucks it out of you. I just feel like when I'm just beginning to enjoy a place and just like breathe, then I'm like, I've already planned the next thing. Maybe I should just slow down, but I also feel like there's a place I want to see. Well, I've got the energy and ability to do so, but I also just am like, sometimes it's nice just to stop for a while. Anyway, I'm leaving, where am I? I'm leaving Manuel Antonio now and going to Corcovado. This is Mr. JC.
How are you? Davina, mate.
The manager of the Hotel Vista Serena. He's so epic. He's made our stay so cool. Thank you, Mr. JC.
Pura vida.
Pura vida. We'll come back again soon. For sure. All right, bye. Goodbye. Hey, let's go to the taxi. It's for the YouTube vlog. Getting in a taxi. Okay. Yeah. Ask. Hi, hola. Can we put our bags in the boot? Hola.
¿Cómo estás?
Sí, gracias. Okay, vale.
There's okay to put this one girl at the hostel down there on the right side.
We can pick her up on the way to Kepos. One pickup.
It's just on the way to Kepos. There, this one hostel.
But in Teba.
Yeah,
Teba.
Okay, you go to Kepos.
Yeah.
Okay, you needed a stop in Teba.
Yeah.
Okay, no problem.
Yeah. Gracias.
She has more luggage.
We can put it in the bags. In the bag. Saying the drive to Corcovado is crazy?
Yeah, it's crazy because it's a long distance.
How many hours?
Okay, to Sierpe? Maybe in autobus? 2 hours and a half.
That's fine.
2 hours and a half.
From San Jose to here, I need like 5 hours.
Yeah.
5 hours because it's maybe you. It's because the highway is closed. The highway is closed. It's closed for the clean the way.
Because we did a huge.
Yeah. I don't know. Maybe 2 hours and a half or 3 hours because the bus to here not is direct.
Yeah.
It's many stops.
Okay.
Yeah, to Sierpe, to Corcovado. Maybe 1 hour and a half. Yeah. How much you pay for the boat?
I guess so.
That is wild. Oh my gosh. Look how cute.
Oh my gosh.
It's sad if they're gonna be like slaughtered. I don't know how I feel about that.
Oh my god.
Thank you. Got it. Doing some casual vlogging for the YouTube channel. Waiting for the bus to get to Sierpe. Woo!
the locker boxes.
So, like, how do we know which is the one?
They called it out, but they said just to wait around for like 12, 15. These are my new friends. We're waiting for the bus to the airport. The question is whether it comes and like which platform it's from and what time. It's still all a mystery.
Will we make our bus?
Yeah. There's a lot of connections here that are all hanging by a very loose thread. But that's the Costa Rican way. Like, people have said different things to us the entire time. Stay tuned.
Okay, go.
Just wondering if this bus is going to London. If it does, that would be an epic bus ride. Probably a bus that can go in the ocean. See you later, London bus.
Hello! Little soft law.
Central American timing, it is completely left up to fate, and let's hope we get to Drake Bay. We are all exhausted, but that's the way traveling goes sometimes, huh? That's all part of the adventure. Let's just try to embrace it all and see where this takes us. Oh my gosh.
Seven a.m. and like six p.m.
Such weird timings. This is where you get the boat from. This is the river.
So, where did you see?
You guys are too cute. Classic Central American timing. It took us from boarding over half an hour before the boat started moving, but we're finally moving again. And it is pretty. These are my friends. Say hi.
just got to the Corcovado Jungle Hostel in Drake Bay, and it's literally on a whole beach to itself. It is great.
Dipping in so long.
Would you hold this for a second?
Yes, I would.
Oh, I should have won something.
Okay. I put sandals on, yeah. No, it's not. Wait, what?